Scott Stoney joins us now. Scott, you told me when I was at the performance a few days ago, you love to act. We all know that. You've seen Scott act a bunch, a ton down here at the Human Race. Not so hot on the directing, though, until something really gets you interested. In this show, you were like, I'm doing it.
Absolutely. Absolutely. I saw it in 2004 on Broadway, and I've been campaigning for it ever since.
So what hooked you? What said, I got to do this?
Well, number one, the music. The music is just fabulous, you know. I mean, you can't sit still. It's rhythm and blues, but there's also klezmer, and there's also pastiche music from the 30s and 40s. I mean, there's just all kinds of really interesting stuff. Plus, when you've got, you know, I'm into fantasy. I've always been into fantasy, and this show has a washing machine that sings and a dryer that sings and a moon that comes to life. So, I mean, it was right up my alley.
And a great cast, too. Talk about the cast.
Well, they're great. It's a cast of 17. Half of them are from local. They're local, which I'm very proud of. And the other half we found in New York and Chicago.
And then briefly, I know this is tough because this is one of those shows that go, ooh, you got to take a couple minutes. But talk about Caroline Interchange. What happens? What goes on?
Well, Caroline is a domestic worker. She's a maid in 1963 for a Jewish family in Lake Charles, Louisiana. And that right there is pretty crazy because, you know, Northern Jews, Southern Jews, 1963, in the month of November, those of us who remember that certainly remember what happened then. And that certainly has an impact on the events of this play. Caroline is trying to deal with this small boy that's part of this family who's recently lost his mother and has a new stepmother who's trying to curb him of his bad habit of leaving change in his pockets.
There's the Caroliner Chains. Scott, you did great. You put it all in a nutshell. From the Loft Theater, and I feel like I should howl at the moon here. Should I? Really?
Well, you should. It's full.
Jim Booker, two news on your side.